context, because there will be a lot of people watching who know who Hilda Baker is, and there'll be a lot of people watching who are thinking, who's Hilda Baker? But if she was the influence behind all these great comedians that we have today. So she was a very important person for her time.
Oh, definitely, because really nobody was doing it, if you see what I mean, in the 1940s. And I mean, she didn't reach fame until 1955, and even then, women were not, generally speaking, recognised as stand-up comics at all. And her worst problem was that she was, in fact, restricted in those early days by the fact that she was in a man's world. And in fact, there was an awful story once that she, because she ran all her own shows and everything, and she actually was refused by the staff at a theatre. When they discovered she was in charge, they said, "We're not putting your scenery up because you're a woman." Isn't that awful?
Things have changed a little bit.
Changed. But the same applied to being a comedian as well. Yes. The comics hated it because she was getting laughs.
She had one of those very distinctive voices. She was very... Where was she from?
She was actually from Bolton, a little village outside Bolton called Farnworth.
Right.
Plodder Lane, Farnworth.
Plodder Lane,
Farnworth.
She lived. Yes. And she had all these catchphrases. She had lots of catchphrases. Esther does a very good Hilda Baker. Did you see it?
I did, actually. I was a little
quite
bit worried.
Uncanny. She's perfected it in the mirror.
No, I don't think there's any danger of me hopping in there and doing this, but...
Well, you don't look at all like Hilda Baker, but you don't look like Hilda Baker either. But then somebody said you did.
It is quite strange, actually. It was about 10 years ago... No, not 10 years ago. What am I talking about? Seven years ago. When I was playing Fairy Marina in the pantomime with my bicycle and lots of glitter and my eyelashes and the full bit, and I thought I was looking, you know, glamorous Marina, as you do. I mean, it's, you know, a bit of a tall order, that one, but still. And somebody said...
No.
Somebody actually... No? Right, fine. Thank you very much. Thanks, Steve. Somebody afterwards said, "You know, when you're working with the audience, you remind me of Hilda Baker." And I fell about. I said, "Sorry." I said, you know, tall and blonde, she was short and dark and so on. I thought, this is very strange. But to cut a long story short, I did admit that when I was 10, I used to do impersonations of her, which I did.
You used to do impersonations?
I did, yes. And then he suggested I did some research because she was a genius, brilliant, etc., etc. And he said, "You must do some research because otherwise she'll be forgotten." Little did I realise, Steve, what was going to be ahead of me for the next 7 years.
7 years, wasn't it?
Yes.
Checking,
I mean, obviously,
it
started in a small way. You know, you start, you get little bits of information. But then I started to get quite intrigued, and I thought, this is fascinating, this story.
She's a woman who should be remembered.
Oh, I was at a book signing the other day, and somebody came up and said, "Oh, that's a wonderful one of you on the front looking like Hilda." And I said, "No, no, I'm on the back. She's on the front, as she would be when it's her book."
Yeah.
And they said, "No, well, that looks just like you in the play," because they'd seen the play.
Oh, okay. Give us a said be soon. Give us some of her things.
I'll give you a little bit of her act.
Yes, give us some of the
This is the historical act. This is before be soon and all of those. But I can do that for you as well.
Because I should point out that in She Knows You Know, the show is split into three halves. So you look at three bits
halves.
Of her life.
Well, it's actually two halves, but we still look at three bits of her life, if you see what I mean.
Does one half have two bits in?
Well, sort of, in a way, because the second half... Here we go. This sounds bizarre, doesn't it? The second half has bits of her act, bits of her rehearsing backstage and front stage, and going back into her dressing room. So you can say that actually it's probably in about four halves.
The nice thing is that this show is on at the Vaudeville Theatre, She Knows You Know, which is also the place that Hilda did her only straight piece.
It's very spooky. There have been an awful lot of very spooky things that have happened, which are obviously all in the book. I mean, there's been too many, really, to document.
Yeah.
And it, whether you believe or not, it has been very, very strange. But the strangest one was that when we were offered the Vaudeville Theatre, it turned out that practically to the week that we opened, exactly 30 years ago, Hilda Baker was opening in the only straight play that she ever did in the West End, apart from musicals and all of the other sort of big variety shows. And not only that, but my play is set backstage at a provincial theatre, and so was that one that she did. Now, she got rave reviews, so we're only hoping, really.
Absolutely. I see no reason why you shouldn't. Well, it's all in the book, which is by Jean Fergusson. A lot of research has gone into this, because this is, you know, a woman who should be remembered, one of the greats of British theatre, one of the great musicals, and people can go and see it on stage at the Vaudeville. Keeping it alive, Jean Fergusson, thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve.